Mayday, mayday, mayday.
Thanks for joining us.
And that's a wrap.
I've flown into a tower. It's one of the electrical towers.
Taking a look at Maryland's biggest stories of 2022. This is the WBAL-TV Year in Review.
Federal indictment alleges that Mosby falsely claimed financial hardship due to the pandemic. The indictment claims between May 26 and December 29th of 2020, Mosby submitted a request to get $40,000 and $50,000 from her city retirement account.
We will honor those who lost their lives today.
The heart of the Baltimore City Fire Department broken in three places tonight.
We pride ourselves on bringing our A game. Sadly, this morning our A game just wasn't quite good enough.
Three of their bravest lose their lives in a fire that began after dawn.
There are no words, none, to describe the pain and the severity of the losses that we suffer today.
A fourth member of the department on life support, as the city says its prayers for the department and those on the front line.
The video is startling. It shows Corporal Annette Goodyear giving the okay for Northeast Middle School student Violet Watt to cross the street after telling an oncoming car to stop. But the car plows into the intersection and Goodyear risks her own life to shove the child out of the way to safety.
The superintendent urged state lawmakers to do away with the masking regulation.
I'm coming here to end the regulation early because I think the conditions are right and it did what it needed to do.
Prices rose overnight in Maryland by 9 cents, according to AAA. And with peak summer season right around the corner, the agency says those prices could rise even more.
A container ship is still stranded off the coast of the Gibson Island in the Chesapeake Bay. The ship, known as the Ever Forward, is still listed as aground on Marine Tracker. Sky Team 11 was over the scene just moments ago, where several tugboats out of Baltimore are trying to assist.
Where the Ever Forward is finally moving in the Chesapeake Bay after being stuck for 5 weeks, and we're going to send it straight up to Captain Roy and Sky Team 11. Third time was the charm, Captain Roy.
Oh yeah, I hear you. I mean, they had several things going for them. The winds were in their favor yesterday when they were still doing their dredging and offloading the containers. And then today they had seven tugboats that they used to pull it free.
Was sitting with her and she started turning blue and choking and then seizing.
Terrified for her child's life, Kirsten dialed 911.
And I was greeted with the message, "I'm sorry, we're experiencing high call volume, please hold." It put me on elevator music and then it disconnected.
Kirsten says she called again and the same thing happened.
There are championship teams and there are legendary championship teams, and the 2022 Maryland men's lacrosse team is now forever in the category of the legends. Terps close out a perfect season beating Cornell this afternoon, winning the national championship 9-7.
One by one, the candidates for the Democratic nomination for governor laid out their plans for Maryland. They addressed crime in Baltimore and around the state. The biggest differences between the candidates were seen when asked about integrity.
Inside Towson Town Center, Apple Store employees made history. This group is the first in the country to unionize. Out of 110 workers eligible to vote, 65 said yes to unionize and 33 said no.
Protesters at the federal courthouse downtown are reacting with anger, fear, and confusion to the Supreme Court decision overturning constitutional protections to abortion. There's also strong reaction from State House presiding officers.
I'm horrified. I'm truly stunned that we've hit this place.
It's a dark day for our country.
I heard a huge boom, crash. I assumed something hit the house. I wasn't sure. I just kept running so I could get underneath something that was safe.
A confirmed EF1 tornado with sustained winds of 90 miles per hour sent a tree through the roof of his bedroom.
A driver, a 48-year-old man, got into an altercation with a group of squeegee workers, pulled over his car, and got out with a bat.
The information that we have right now is that he swung the bat at one or more of those squeegee workers. In return, one of the squeegee workers pulled out a gun and fired, striking this male victim.
Police say he died at the hospital.
Investigative reporter Jane Miller knocks on a lot of doors and asks a lot of questions.
Do you know where those checks are?
Ms. Shattuck, may we speak to you?
Do you intend to remain here?
How hard is it to get here?
Don't you regret at that time saying, boy, that looks bad?
She has broken some incredible stories over her 46-year career, more than 40 here at WBAL-TV.
Some are calling it an infestation. Millions of lantern flies in a number of parts of Harford and Cecil counties, as well as Washington County in western Maryland.
The iconic smokestacks of the CP Crane Generating Station appear to melt to the ground in a controlled implosion.
It was actually amazing. They did a fabulous job because it dropped so fast to see that much structure just gone.
As school let out, the suspect approached the victim and they got into a heated argument. The commissioner says the suspect produced a firearm and shot multiple times. School resource officers were close by. They gave chase, caught the suspect, and recovered a gun close to the crime scene. The suspect was taken into custody without incident.
Three sites in West Baltimore tested positive. They found E. coli and other bacteria in the water. The mayor says they don't know of anyone who has gotten sick from the water yet, but they issued a boil water advisory for an area in West Baltimore, urging folks to boil their water for 1 minute and let it cool before using it for things like drinking, cooking, or giving to pets.
A behind-the-scenes look at Navy and Marine operations from the sea and also from the sky.
It's not every day civilians get a bird's-eye view of the Chesapeake and Patapsco from a Navy helicopter. Before landing on the 610-foot USS Carter Hall to explore the nooks and crannies of the ship.
The pursuit started in East Baltimore after officers spotted an armed suspect in a residential neighborhood. It almost immediately got wild. Look how the suspect's vehicle cuts across a lawn. They drive down a sidewalk. The high-speed chase then continues on I-95. Captain Roy Taylor, following the action, says he clocked the suspect traveling as fast as 134 miles per hour. Watch closely now how the driver totally disregards other motorists, weaving in and out of traffic, and even speeds up, rolling down the shoulder of the interstate. The driver's door and backseat passenger door flings open.
Yep.
Someone in the backseat throws out an object. Then in the middle of I-83, three people bolt from the vehicle. They try to escape by running across the highway.
After two decades behind bars, 41-year-old Adnan Syed walked out free of shackles.
Later, we now know what Adnan and his loved ones have always known, that Adnan's trial was profoundly and outrageously unfair.
Syed had been serving a life sentence for the 1999 murder of his high school classmate and ex-girlfriend, Haman Lee.
Breaking news out of Baltimore County as police have arrested two people in connection to a countywide suspicious package investigation. The new information we're learning from police after a Kearney Middle School and Woodlawn Motel were both evacuated.
The remnants of Ian, the upper level energy that was that hurricane, is drifting through the mid-Atlantic right now. Now, eventually, it's going to develop what we call a nor'easter type storm off the coast of Ocean City. You can see it kind of getting going right there.
He is elated. He is joyful. He is still processing this.
City State's Attorney Marilyn Mosby Tuesday dismissed the criminal case against him, convicted of the 1999 murder of Heyman Lee. Her office was notified Friday that new touch DNA tests on items not examined before exclude him as a suspect.
Folks living near and along Arrington Road in Marriottsville and Carroll County say just before midnight, what they thought was some sort of explosion turned out to be a 2.0 magnitude earthquake with a depth of more than 3 feet. And their neighborhood was pretty much the epicenter.
This can be Maryland's moment.
I intend to put power back in the people's hands.
Republican nominee Dan Cox and Democratic nominee Wes Moore delivered their opening remarks in the gubernatorial debate, and then they took their gloves off, each candidate working to define the other for Maryland voters.
You cannot trust what comes out of my opponent's mouth.
Frankly, I'm standing on stage right now with an extremist election denier.
They sure are. 4,000 runners hitting the streets from all 50 states in the U.S. and from 11 countries.
Robbie Kreese has done it. He crosses the finish line as the winner of the 21st Baltimore Marathon. Julia Roman Duval wins the women's division of the Baltimore Marathon, and she greets the finish line with a huge grin for her second victory in Baltimore.
Hello, everyone. I'm Jason Newton.
And I'm Deborah Wiener. Welcome to this Maryland Peace of Mind special, Meeting the Need. As conversations about mental health become more common, we'd like to help those who are seeking assistance.
For many squeegee workers, their days of working the corners may soon be numbered after the city launches its comprehensive plan to eliminate the activity. Squeegee workers will develop a code of conduct for self-regulation. There will be place-based enforcement, meaning designated areas. Police will enforce criminal activity. Drivers will also be held accountable.
Maryland voters making history tonight. Democrat Wes Moore, now the first African-American to be elected as governor in the state, beating out his Republican challenger, State Delegate Dan Cox.
Let's take a look at where the numbers stand right now. Let's take a look right here. It's on your screen right now. With 58% of the precincts reporting, we have 44-year-old Democrat Wes Moore with 60% of the vote, 48-year-old Republican Dan Cox with 37% of the vote. The Associated Press called the race for Moore earlier tonight, and this means that Moore's running mate Aruna Miller, a native of India, makes history as the first immigrant to be elected to statewide office. She is also the first woman of color to be elected lieutenant governor. Fire crews are still on the scene of a condo explosion in Montgomery County.
It happened around 8:30 this morning. It left 12 people injured, including 4 children. Tonight, 2 adults are critical and some people are still unaccounted for. People in the area tell 11 News tonight it felt like a bomb went off.
And I'm just going onto the walk, and then when I get to the front of the complex, that's when I hear this loud, quick pop. And it just shook everything and all the car alarms went off instantly.
Tonight, 4 buildings housing 24 units remain evacuated. The medical examiner identified the subject found amid the rubble yesterday as 36-year-old Juan Pablo Marshall Quiznon. Police say he died by suicide. Police also say Wednesday morning at 11:30, there was a 911 call reporting Mr. Quiznon as missing and suicidal.
From
On WBAL-TV 11, this is Breaking News.
I was at the market, it was like a big boom. So I didn't know if it was like a bomb or was like something exploded, or but it was just like boom.
A row home explosion sends shockwaves throughout Pigtown.
Sky Team 11 was over the scene on Bayard Street the moment crews found a person alive underneath the rubble there. So far, we know three people have serious injuries.
11 News reporter David Collins joins us live from the scene after talking to firefighters and witnesses. David.
Well, Stan, many neighbors rushed to the scene after hearing cries for help. One got hurt attempting to make an heroic rescue.
And on behalf of the mayor, I officially present a key to the city.
My goodness.
What? Baltimore thanks you for 50 years of service.
Wow. Thank you very much. And would you please tell Mayor Brandon Scott, he said thank you very much. I'm very honored by this. I really am. A huge thank you to all of my friends and teammates here at WBAL-TV. I have reaped the benefits of finishing on top because of the very strong support and cast around me and behind me. And finally, thank you to my children. You know, it hasn't been easy being the child of a local news anchor. Like your dad, your lives have constantly been under a microscope with higher than normal expectations. But you have handled it with grace, dignity, respect, and I'm proud of the loving, caring, successful young adults you've grown to be. So I love you and thank you. And while I may be stepping away from the anchor desk, I'll still be living in the area. So if you see me around town, say hello to this old fella. Okay? So thank you. Again, I love all of you. And as they say for the last time, that's it for 11 News at 6. Thanks for joining us. And that's a wrap. Two people recovering this morning after a small plane crashed into power lines in Montgomery County.
Yeah, crews rescued the pilot and the passenger early this morning after they spent hours trapped in the plane.
I was flown into a tower to the northwest of Gaithersburg Airport. It's one of the electrical towers, and believe it or not, the aircraft is pinned in the tower. And I don't know how long we're going to be able to stay here.
Baltimore, we do crabs and Old Bay and football, but we really do, we do Christmas well. And I don't mean just Christmas trees. What about a Christmas tree made of hubcaps or dinosaurs? Bob Hodges has been here from the beginning. Bob, where in the world did you get an idea to deck out a whole block?
I'll tell you what, many years ago, the neighbor across the street couldn't hear my Christmas music. He asked me to run a speaker over, and I put lights on that line. And the neighbor said, why don't you string lights across the street? And the rest, as they say, is history.
We are on 83 right now, up in the northern Baltimore County area. We have seen that ice, however, on our side view mirror. We've seen some icicles hanging from that and around the mirror. We've also seen some icicles hanging from some of the guardrails. So definitely some evidence of some icy conditions out there. Like I said, right now, the rain is coming down a little harder than what we've seen probably in the past hour or so. The roads are wet and they're slick. Watch your speed and be cautious, even though you might not be able to see icy spots. Sometimes it's hard to identify, so you just want to be careful just in case.
You may be used to seeing Maryland lottery drawings like this on your TV screen. These are the lottery drawings Patrick Morton has managed for 20 years. But come December 19th, that system will change.
No more rolling machines out of a secure vault into a TV studio. No more placing ping pong balls in each chamber one by one and counting them endlessly. Now it's a computer.